So how you want to start it?
How you usually start it, man? Like, what type? What is this? You have so many. You have a few things going on right now. Is this Social Proof Podcast?
Yeah.
Okay. So what's up, everybody? Welcome to another edition of the Social Proof Podcast.
You gotta say the name right. You
can't. Social Proof Podcast. It was a tongue twister a little bit. You know what I'm saying? I mean, you know, we could do it again. Why not?
Nah, let's do it.
Hey, what's up, everybody? Welcome to another edition to the Social Proof Podcast.
That's good.
I am your host just for today, Mr. J. Hill. For the guys and for the ladies and gentlemen who don't know who I am Mr. J. Hill. I am a personality, a podcaster as well. David Shands is a great friend of mine. Not only a great friend, he's a mentor of mine. One of the only few. Probably one of the only few mentors. Why is that in this space.
And I don't expect to be your mentor. Like, I don't look at you as a... I don't look at this as a mentor-mentee relationship, because you give me game, I give you game. Mm. But why is that uncomfortable for you? Well, never mind, because this is my...
Yeah, it's just... Interview. Yeah, I'm just from Baltimore, but I'm a... This is just... I'm still rough around the edges a little bit, you know what I'm saying? I don't really give out them titles too often, you feel me? But, yeah, man, we got... David Shane's in the building, everybody.
Oh, happy to be here, man. Thanks for allowing me to be on my show.
Yes, sir. Yo, thank you for opening the platform for me, man. This for sure. This is great. This is a great opportunity for sure. And I want people to understand how big of an opportunity it is for me. And just because you're my friend, I don't want people to think I'm just saying that just because you're my friend. So I want to let you know that. I want to give you your flowers for that, because you deserve that, outside of the friendship, outside of the mentorship, but just because what you do and what you continue to do in this space. So
yeah, no, I appreciate you, man. I was thinking through like this whole concept of like I want to have someone talk to me about like kind of the events and stuff like that. And I'm thinking, who would be able to do it? And like, literally, you are one of my favorite interviewers, and that's not an easy skill, bro. Mm. That's not. Most people just ask people the same questions, or the questions that people expect to be asked. But you really are just, I like the way you think when it comes to interviewing. So we about to have a good time, man.
I got a couple questions I got in mind. So, if it rub you wrong, don't just charge it to my brain and not my heart.
Right? Oh yeah, no, that's cool. Right. I don't think I can be offended. Oh. Try it. Just try.
No, I don't want to.
Do your best.
No.
Go at it.
No. I would never.
You get full permission.
This ain't the hot seat. That's for you, brother.
No, what I'm saying is ask, so you can ask whatever you want to ask. You can't ruffle my feathers.
This ain't why I'm here. But why I am here is because of the podcast summit.
Yeah.
Right. This is what, your second
year.
Second year of doing this. Yeah. Why, bro? Like, why do you care so much? Like, you're trying to get everybody to do podcasts, creating content. Like, why? Like, what is it to you?
When you really are into something, you kind of hope other people are into it too. You know what I mean? So I play Monopoly a lot. And when I'm around other people, I'm like, I get so excited when someone else plays Monopoly.
For sure.
Like, if you know how to play, like a real Monopoly player, you know what I mean? Like, I get hype, bro. I add you to the group chat.
Yeah.
We got a group chat and we play every day pretty much virtually.
Right.
But it, like, podcasting, it just seems like the new wave, bro. I feel like I'm telling people to buy Bitcoin when it was $10. Like, I feel like podcasting is... it's the strongest medium out right now, because we would listen to the radio and most of it is music. It's short bits of you getting to hear this disc jockey, but you only get like a short, you only get a little bit of the person, you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. Or even if you're a basketball fan, how much LeBron do you get? Like 48 minutes every couple days, maybe. But like, we're giving... For a season in basketball, but we literally talk to our audience once, twice, three times. Some people do it every single week for an hour, and you get that conversation week after week, month after month, year after year. And there's no stronger way to build an audience than podcasting. So I just think everyone needs to do it for a couple of reasons. One, to build a following and an audience, but two, it's helped me become a much better communicator. Much better communicator.
what they got to do with everybody else? Like, you're doing that. You build your audience. It's great. You are successful at podcasting. But even down to your point of monopoly, for me, it's spades, right? Yeah, if you like to play spades, we can be partners. I'll add you to the group chat, but I'm not about to teach you how to play spades. That's something that you got to do way before you get to the table. So you're trying to influence people to get to do podcasts, right? We're telling people to get rid of the mics, throw them away, send them back. You telling them to buy more mics.
Yeah.
And you're saying because like you love podcasting, but you love it. So you continue to do it.
Yeah.
Why do you care for everybody else to do it?
There's nothing that, you ever ate at a really good restaurant and you like, yo, you got to try that joint? I think we were talking about Baltimore. You're like, yo, you got to try the crab legs and all that. Why are you hype, bro? Yeah. Like, why are you so hype?
Because
you had a good experience.
That's where I come from. That means a little more. And it means different.
Bro, what do you mean?
I'm not telling everybody to go to my barber. No. Mm-mm. Of course not.
That's selfish.
You can, hey, because eventually I ain't going to be able to get in there. So no, you can't. Everybody can't have that information.
Right, but that's not the same thing, I don't think. Yo, there are so many people in, as we all elevate, right, to other levels, you might go to a high school and teach them how to do exactly what you did, right?
Yeah.
Because you know the alternative. They're going to go outside. They're going to be with their street friends and all that kind of stuff. You in there like, yo, you really got to start something. Have a good idea. Da-da-da. Like, yo, you can get in this media thing. Learn TikTok. Learn YouTube. You'll be pressing that because, one, those kids ain't your competition. But when you stop looking at even your peers as competition, you say, yo, you need to do it. Mm-hmm. I'm encouraging people that have a bigger following than me. Yo, you need to start a podcast that's in the same space as me. Because I still don't look at you as my competition. If I looked at you as my competition, you wouldn't be here, Jay.
No, for sure.
Yeah, I mean, I'd be like, yo, and I think you're a better interviewer than me. So, but I would still say, yo, let me continue to give Jay a platform. We did the event together. Like, I wanted you a podcast on, but you had your baby. And like, it's, I don't look at people as my competition, but I do understand that if someone's trying to build a following in an audience in 2024, there's no better way to do it than podcasting, period.
Yo, so I want to paint a picture real quick. How long have you been doing the podcasting?
2018.
Before that, you were selling t-shirts you had a couple kiosks.
Yeah.
And you had a store at once, right?
Yep.
So you were like, is safe to say you were successful before you started doing podcasts?
No. No. Well, it depends on what you call. What do you call success? How are you defining it?
You had a store.
Yes.
You had not one kiosk.
Yeah.
You had multiple kiosks.
And what does that mean to you?
You want to come? You want to come over here and be around?
No. I'm asking you. What do you think that means?
That means you were successful enough to run a business on a larger scale, far larger than just me getting some t-shirts and selling it on Instagram.
You know, when someone says that to me, if I was in your seat, you know what that means to me?
What does it mean?
Oh, you had two kiosks. Oh, they $2,000 a piece. Oh, that's $4,000. Oh, you had a store that was $3,000. Oh, so you had $7,000 every month. And then who running all them joints? Oh, so you had $12,000-$15,000 a month in overhead. But the first $15,000 that you sell in apparel goes to rent. So even if, we're making $30,000, $40,000 a month, it don't mean that, bro. When I had the store, that year I made $250,000. I actually walked home with like 20 something. So what do you mean by successful exactly? Just like, I mean, I need you to paint the picture. I'm trying to understand what you mean by this.
The picture that I'm painting is, yeah, we all know that. Different levels, different devils, right? Yeah. And when you get to a level of success, a lot of this goes back into the business. Yeah. I get that. I'm not having that conversation with you, though. I'm not talking to you as a peer, as somebody that understands that. I'm talking to you from somebody that doesn't know that.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like, I think you're so, I don't want to say far removed, but you're so far into this entrepreneurship space that you probably don't remember those days. And I'm pretty sure
I remember them vividly.
Okay, and I'm pretty sure it was a day where you was like, man, I can't wait till I get a kiosk. It was a day where you're like, I can't wait till I get a store. You had two stores. I mean, you had one store, two kiosks.
Yes.
Right?
Yes.
So you cannot ignore that, the fact that you were successful. That was a successful business that you was running.
100%.
That don't mean you was the richest. The richest. Cool. You were successful, right?
You know. I mean, it. Are you successful?
Yes, I'm successful. For sure.
All right, cool.
For sure. I'm successful. I have a long way to go, but I would be an idiot, a fool not to acknowledge the success that I've had.
Okay, yes, I was, successful.
Okay, cool. In my space, I think.
But I do remember, I remember almost every day of every stage of it.
Mm-hmm.
It just never felt like success because there was always struggle and there was always stress and there was always like me trying to figure it out. So that's why even the word successful is like so like blurry to me. You know what I mean? Like how you define it.
Yeah, I mean, so is life though. It's always going to be a problem. Even in the biggest house, you're going to have an issue.
And I interrupt your question. Let me see where you're going with this.
It's okay. But I ask that because I'm looking at your platform and then I'm looking at where you came from as well.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm like, it almost could make somebody feel like, damn, do I really need money to have a really successful podcast? Because I feel like you came into the game with a couple of dollars.
But that's fair. That's fair. So your question is?
Do you think you would be as successful as you are if you didn't have the money, the capital that you had coming into podcasting?
Yeah, bro. So the whole reason I was doing the podcast.
So why is fair? Hold on. I'm sorry. Not to cut you off. I'm being a terrible interviewer. Okay. You said that was fair. But then you said you still would be as successful if you didn't have the money.
Yeah. Here's my challenge with the question is like, would I be a successful podcaster if I didn't already have a business going?
No, what you're saying? No, that ain't what I asked. If you didn't already have the capital, if you didn't already have the money.
That's what I'm trying to get you to understand. I didn't have no money. So look, listen to me.
Mm-hmm.
When I started the podcast, it was to promote an event.
Mm-hmm.
I thought there was going to be 1,000 people there, and 1,000 people, I'm like, ooh, I'm going to be up 30,000, 40,000. We had 550 people there. I had to give away tickets, and I didn't have much money to put into it. My thing is, I didn't put no money in it. Like, my whole goal for interviewing people was to sell tickets. So if you was a speaker, I'm like, yo, let me interview Jay Hill, because at the end of the interview, I'm hoping that somebody listens and says, oh, I want to meet Jay Hill. So they'll come at whatever the date was to this particular event.
Mm-hmm.
So I didn't have any money to put into the podcast at all. I didn't have no team at all. I'm setting up the cameras. All them first interviews, I set up a camera. There's two seats. I'm like, yo, I invited you to come do the interview. I set up the lights. I set up the cameras. We had this in the studio. It was like an all white area, like a white psych wall. The floor, we had to paint white, and then it was the wall and then a little psych part. So after every interview, we had to paint it, or before. If there's an event, we gotta paint the floor white. So I get in there early and I paint the floor. Then you wait for it to dry, then you set up the chairs, and then you set up the tripod, one camera. I got lapel mics. I put one on me. You come, I'm like, oh, Jay, appreciate it. I'm gonna put the mic on you. And you sit down, I hit record on the audio. You sit down, I hit record on the camera, then I run around to the camera, go sit down, and then I wait for a second to a point where we can edit. I'm saying, hey, welcome to the, we don't have a podcast name right now, but we're going to come up with a name soon. Look at them first episodes. You'll see that. Mm-hmm. And I would, after the episode was done, a bunch of those episodes, the audio stopped recording for some reason because the card was full, or the video wasn't recording, or it was slightly blurry. You know, you set up a camera and it's mm-hmm. like slightly out of focus, and I'm too detail oriented. It frustrates me to know, and I can't put that out. So I take the card home and I put it in my computer and I edit the podcast. And then when I say edit, I just take the front off and the back off and put like our names on there. And then I upload it to YouTube.
Mm-hmm. I don't want you to think that I'm trying to overlook the process and the hard work that you put in.
Yeah. But I'm saying I didn't put any money into it. And people didn't listen to the podcast because there was some marketing money behind it, or there was some fancy anything.
But you were somebody that they wanted to listen to. David, you said you had your event. You wanted 1,000 people at your event. You got 500 people.
I wasn't the one speaking on the interviews. I'm interviewing you.
Right.
I'm introducing an audience of people to somebody that they don't know. At this point back then, you interview like celebrities and influencers. I interview now entrepreneurs or somewhat celebrities.
Mm-hmm.
When I started this interview process, you don't go to the airport and see your favorite entrepreneur and say, hey, I'll follow you. It wasn't like that.
Now, so you don't think you was somebody for people to pull up?
Because
I'm listening to you and you saying, bro, I wanted 1,000 people at my event. Bro, I threw events I started doing.
Yeah.
And when you start events, maybe this is my experience and I might be selling myself short, but we always be like, the good number is 100, right? You wanted 1,000 people. So it was something that you saw. It was something in you. Some people you was around to be like, I want 1,000 people. You fell short and had 500 people. People back home, from what I know, when they have good events, 500 people don't even come out. So you had 500 people come out here, yeah, out to your event, and you saying, they won't listen for me. They would listen for the guests I had come on.
I didn't even speak at my first event.
Okay.
So maybe back home, if the bar wasn't set so low where you at, then 500 would be normal and everybody would be shooting 4,000.
In Atlanta, it ain't 500 people that go to the club every week.
Bro, the event I had before that had like, what do you mean? What? In Atlanta, 500 people in
the club? Not every club. It's people who been doing parties and stuff and be falling short all the time.
You're right, but I hit a gear where I'm talking about entrepreneurship, where people want to be entrepreneurs. And I'm saying I was talking about the point where you said, do you think if I didn't have money, the podcast would take off? And I didn't have money to put into it. I have been grinding in the city for years.
Okay.
At this point.
How long?
So I quit my job in 2012. I quit my job in 2012.
Cheesecake Factory.
I quit Cheesecake Factory October 2012. Yes. And I opened the kiosk October 1st, 2012. Yep. I bought a bunch of Instagram followers. I didn't buy them. What? I didn't buy them. It was a guy that DM'd me like, yo, you should have more followers. I like your content.
Oh, so
and my following when I was trying so hard back then. Getting 1,000 followers, it was a big deal.
Yeah, it was.
1,000 followers. So I'm at like, 800, 900, something like that. And the dude was like, "Yo, I watched one of your videos because I put up like a video about sleepers for suckers or whatever." And he's like, "Yo, I like your content. You should have people need to be following you." And I go to sleep. I'm like, "All right, cool." I go to sleep, he wakes up, he gives me 5,000 followers. I wake up with 5,000 some odd followers. 2 weeks later, I'm at like 7,000, which means that 5,000 showed other people that I'm cool, and I got 2,000 more because I had 5,000 supposedly. So I wasn't lit, bro.
But even that's kind of showing what I'm saying. You see how people work?
Mm-hmm.
Perfect example. You bought 5,000 followers, and just because people thought
he gave them to me, bro.
Like, boy, these entrepreneurs, boy, I swear
they
be like, man, it's not this, it's this.
I didn't even ask for him. He was just like, yo, I'm gonna hold you down,
boy. But anyway, you see how you had 5,800 followers, right?
Yeah.
And just off the rap, just off of that, people was like, man, he's somebody I want to follow him.
Yes,
that's where I'm going with this. If it's the money, if it's the you had something.
I had fake followers. What are you talking
but
about?
But no, you just proved, you said, I got 5,000 followers, right? He gave me 5,000 followers. Yeah. Because I had 5,000 followers, other people thought I was important, so they followed me. So I got 2,000 real followers off the fact that I had 5,000 followers.
Yes.
That's what you're saying. So
but
what I'm saying-
I did nothing special. You could have bought some followers at that point.
Forget that. What I'm saying is, in the podcast space, right? Because we're going back to the podcast summit. What I'm saying is, you came into the podcast game, somebody. You were successful. You had two kiosks. You had a store. You were somebody who could get 500 people in a room.
Yes.
That was you.
Yes, for sure.
And I'm asking, even if it's not the money, do you think this podcast would be as successful if that wasn't you already? Just like, would you think you would have got 2 extra thousand followers if you didn't have 5?
100,000%, yes.
Yo, what's up, Social Proof family? So I know you're watching a dope episode, and we'll get right back into it. But in the next 2 minutes, I want to teach you the number one mistake that's probably costing you over $10,000 in taxes. And then I'm going to teach you how to fix it. And at the end, I have a free gift for you. So let's get right into it. So the number one mistake that most people make, especially business owners, is they have the wrong entity set up. Like, guys, LLCs do not help you save on taxes. So let me give you what I call my entity timeline so you can know when to have the best entity for you and how to save the most money on taxes, okay? So step one, before you have the business, I do want you to set up your LLC, but not for tax savings, for asset protection. So you can go to a free website like llcuniversity.com. It's gonna teach you how to set up your LLC 100% free. Now, you're gonna stay an LLC until your business makes over $40,000 in net income for the year. Once your business makes over $40,000 net income for the year, it's time for you to upgrade that LLC to a S corporation. S corporations actually help you save on taxes. How much so? Well, let's put it like this. If you had an LLC making $100,000 and I had an S corp making $100,000, you would pay over $10,000 more in taxes than I would because I have the proper entity. So once you make over $40,000 in net income, it's time for you to upgrade that LLC to an S corp. And then you're gonna stay an S corp until you start making over $3 million in profit. And then it might make sense to upgrade to a C corp. But that's it, guys. LLC where you start the business, S corp where you make over 40K, C corp after $3 million in profit. If you want a free guide on this, I'm gonna give you my tax-free ebook, 100% free, and I'm gonna be teaching a class breaking the ebook down for you, all this 100% free, but it's only for my Social Proof family. So all you have to do is text the word proof to 312-847-2309. That's proof to 312-847-2309. Now let's get back to the episode.
Do you know why?
Why?
Because there's people that's doing it every day. You didn't know them yesterday. Now they lit the day. The girl, Bobby Aloff?
Terrible example.
Was she lit already?
Was Bobby kind of, yes, she was. She was lit on TikTok. Do y'all not know? Come on, man.
Bobby was lit on TikTok?
You said no. You can't say I don't know when you first said no. Yeah, she was lit on TikTok.
I have other examples for sure. Let me think.
And she got money behind her. She got people pushing her. That was a terrible example. People are saying she's an industry plant.
She's an industry plant.
People were saying she's an industry plant.
She did a situation with Marco, and Marco is the one, I think, that put her on the map.
Who is that?
There's a million... Academic, yeah. Anybody that thinks, and I don't think you think that, but anybody that thinks that people become successful in the media space solely because they're already successful is crazy.
Mm.
Crazy.
Okay.
Megan Ashley was B. Simone's assistant. Came on, they built something incredible together. Now, I know what you'll say. Well, she was next to B. Simone. Okay. But there's a million examples of people who started out. Okay. But yo, anybody else, everybody
give me
has,
a name.
Everybody has something, bro. Everybody has something. So that's like saying, that's like saying that you can't be successful unless you're already successful. That's crazy.
So I'm not saying that. I guess my question is, what I'm trying to get at is we live in a very microwavable society, right? Mm-hmm. We want it now, right? Mm-hmm. Like, Instagram is not even Instagram.
Side note, Finesser, he just got out of jail and went crazy.
Bro, he didn't just got out of jail and go crazy. I love Finesse.
Oh.
But do you know why he was arrested?
Yeah, he's a Finesser. He's done with his story.
Okay, cool. So all I'm saying, forget all that. All I'm saying, shout out my dog. All I'm saying is, when you having this summit,
mm-hmm.
and... as somebody who don't know any better, right? I know better. I'm asking questions to invoke emotions.
Of course.
Right?
I'm enjoying it.
When you're having somebody who don't know anything, right? I'm looking like, man, I'm coming to the podcast summit because this is an opportunity. I can be David Shands.
Yeah.
And I don't think that's necessarily true, or is it?
No, it's not true. They can't be David Shands. But there's a corner, there's a pocket of people in this world that will, and I truly believe this with everything in my heart, there is a pocket of people in this world who will only listen to you. Mm. Like, that will follow you, period. I have an interview, bro. I have an interview with the same people you have an interview with. And, well, you, I think you're a better interviewer, but if, say we had the same skill set, for some reason, every month your joint go viral. You got a clip that goes viral. And I don't off rip just think, oh, well, maybe he's just better. Well, in that area, like in that genre, you are in the perfect genre, perfect area. I think your questions are tailored to a specific group of blogs or whatever. And they just pick it up on a regular basis. If everybody here, there are some people that will not listen to me, they will not listen to you, but if Zell start a podcast, they will be raving Zell fans. That's the, all, there's going to be something unique about you. All right, for instance, oh, here we go. I have a perfect example. Oh, you're not going to say it's perfect, but I'm on tour with E.T., Inky Johnson, Willie Moore Jr., Jeremy Anderson.
Sheesh.
And I had just not too long left my job at the Cheesecake Factory. But CJ saw something in me. He's like, yo, I want you to be on tour with us and speak because I think you got a talent, right? So this is maybe a couple years after I left my job. So in the very beginning, and I don't know if y'all know Inky Johnson, but he's one of my top five speakers of all time.
Yeah.
Dead or alive. So first off, Willie Moore Jr., nationally syndicated radio show, like the GOAT, communication out of this world. He starts it off, hypes it up, does his thing. Inky Johnson comes on stage, blazes the stage. I'm talking about, it's people in there. There's a heaviness, a weight in the room, and they're all inspired. So Inky leaves, and then Jeremy comes up, and he be in his spiritual bag too. So people crying and all that. Like, it's a bigger weight, right? And then I got to go up after that. I don't really have an emotional bone in my body. I got jokes. And I'm not like motivational or anything like that. So I'm intimidated, bro. I'm like really, really shook because in the first couple cities was kind of rough and CJ had to like coach me through it because now I'm preparing to set the stage for ET because he comes out last and he kills it. So I felt like I had to be those guys and it was just falling flat and CJ's like coaching me through it. And then I found my groove, I found my rhythm and CJ was like, yo, just be yourself. Like the reason I got you here is because you represent the regular average person. I don't got a story like Inky. Inky lost his arm playing football and then became a multimillionaire. Jeremy used to kick people doors in selling drugs and all kind of stuff. And then he like gave his life to the church. And now he's like this new person and he's married and all that. I'm like, dang, that's a crazy story. E.T. homeless, eating out of trash cans. Bruh, I'm thinking I don't have a story at all. I was working at the Cheesecake Factory. Bro, I ain't never experienced, I've experienced not one level of trauma as a child. No molestation. I didn't grow up in the hood. I ain't never seen nobody get shot in front of me. Not with a single mother raising five kids. I had both my parents. We had like a backyard and grass in the front with the sidewalk.
Hey, relax,
and
bro.
The little strip in front of the sidewalk.
Know who you in front of, bro.
No, I'm just
you
saying. I'm just saying, my kids, like we were kids. My parents just sent us outside. Go play, bro. I had bikes coming up. Every birthday we did something cool.
We get
cool.
It, bro. Keep going.
I'm just saying. Then I grow up. I go to college. I do terrible in college. Terrible in high school, and then I just get a regular job. And I'm I'm a regular person.
There we go.
Regular. But that gave me some insecurity because I'm like, well, I don't feel like I have a story at all. But I would get off stage, and there's people like, yo, bro, I came here for E.T. and Inky and Jeremy and those guys. He said, yo, I didn't even know you, but you was my favorite speaker. Mm. He's like, yo, nobody else really, like, really affected me the way you affected me. And I'm just teaching like some entrepreneurship, go from your job to your dream stuff. And it happened city after city, more and more people. And I got a line of people that are waiting to talk to me. And I was like, yo, I asked CJ, like, yo, what made you put me on this lineup, bro? He's like, yo, I needed somebody regular. But there's a group of people who never heard of you before, but once they hear you, they will be raving fans. And some of those people are following me to this day, to where people are now saying, oh, well, you already have a following of people, but I've been putting in this work since nobody knew who I was for a speaker. I was just selling t-shirts. So for those people that are thinking, I have to have a following already, or I have to have some money, I have to, you don't need none of that. You need to start putting your message out to the world, and those people will find you. But if you don't put your message out, nobody's going to find you.
Is this something that you teach at the summit, though?
Yeah, finding your unique voice. Got to find your unique voice.
Not just finding a unique voice, but gaining an audience, right? Like gaining 100%. Your audience.
Yeah, there's three levels. Starting a podcast, growing a podcast, and monetizing. But it's not just podcasting. So starting a podcast goes into, how do you set up a camera? How do you create content? How do you really get some quality looking content, right? So one of the topics are creating a something, I forgot the name of it, but it's pretty much creating an amazing look for cameras of all budgets with my man Omar Altakori. So starting a podcast, the setup of a camera, whatever, but also growing it. So not just a podcast itself. We got Mahdi Water coming to teach you how he's been able to grow hundreds of thousands of followers in a very short period of time on social media. I'm right now looking for someone who understands the algorithm of TikTok and how to grow on TikTok. So it's really for all content creators. And you'll find your way in these 30 plus sessions that are going on. And then for my people that's trying to make money, it's not just making money on a podcast. We will get through that for sure. YouTube monetization, downloads. I'm looking for advertisers to come and sponsor a podcast. I'm trying to do like a $10,000 sponsorship from an ad agency. But also, how do you use this electrifying form of media to grow a traditional business? So we got to throw the word podcast out of our mind. I'm trying to teach you how to create content so you can be whatever you want to be, or build whatever you want to build, or make whatever you want to make in this content space. And some people aren't going to do it because they want to start a podcast, but because they see the rising trend of podcasting and they see where it's going, you want to get in the way. So there are a lot of people who have a company, right? You have a podcast, Doug, you want to get on podcasts. There are people, let's say I'm that guy, that will charge you every single month to make sure I get you guests on your podcast, because you don't want to have to do that work and go find them. You'll pay me every single month to connect you with podcasters, because you don't want to call and try to figure out if you can get on the show. If I already have the relationship, I'll build a relationship with both of y'all and I'll make millions in between this. But because we understand what's going on in the podcasting space. So it's so many different avenues to talk through. And that's why last year it was a mind blowing experience. Too bad I just lost money because it was in Miami and it was ridiculous price, but they loved it.
But I mean, you're doing it for a good cause, right?
Yeah. But that's why I'm doing it again. I'm just doing it in Atlanta.
You don't need the money, right?
I need the money.
It's just it's charity, right?
Bro, my kids eat every day. It's just charity. Like, you want to eat again today? It's crazy. All of them. It's wild.
Yo, so wait. So all of these workshops, for say, is going on at the same time?
Yeah. So we have three sessions going on simultaneously. So you can pick your experience. So you don't need all 30 workshops. There's some specific stuff that you need to learn, and you'll be able to see the agenda and say, okay, I'm gonna go to this one, I'm gonna go to this one at this hour, like that. So
it's really a workshop, right? It's hands-on. It's not like, because nowadays, bro, talking about these summits and these festivals, and it really ain't teaching you nothing. There's a bunch of people who is so-called somebody. It's really measuring vanity metrics, to be honest. Like, who can get the biggest people at my event to show you that I'm that guy? So, like, I've been to a couple of these ones, and it's like, bro, I pay this money get this VIP experience. And there's people telling me that story. Bro, I don't need to hear your story, bro. Tell me how I can get it. Show me. People are like, you got to do this. I don't need a motivational speech.
Well, some people need a motivational speech. So I went to a conference a little while ago. I didn't learn anything.
I will say the name.
Huh?
Oh, all right, yeah.
What you mean?
Go ahead. I know which one you're talking
you
about.
You went?
Yeah.
Oh,
I've been to a few of them. You gave me the situation for
it. Yeah, it was cool.
Stop playing. You just said you ain't learned nothing.
I didn't learn anything.
So how was it cool?
Because I left with... So it's not always about what you get taught. Sometimes about what you get... which was caught. What you... take away.
For me,
an entrepreneur, check this out. I need to see one thing that can, like, for your podcast and your whole business, it's not 100 things that's going to change your business. It's really one or two tweaks that you can take away that will drastically change the tide of everything you're doing right now. The goal is to find those one or two. So it's not about, so that joint was, it was super just motivational and all that kind of stuff, right? But I was like, man, this is crazy. But then I found two people that I'm gonna be able to make some money with. Or I'm looking at the production and how they did it. I'm like, one, don't seem like that's good production. I'm starting talking to somebody else. They must have took an L in this city because it was a lot of empty seats. And I was like, well, they do them every month. Every month? The only one, two, they do that every month.
Sheesh.
Think about the speakers that was on stage. They do it every single month. There's a formula here. There's another game being played that we just don't see. So my mind goes to, how can they afford to give away tickets? Somebody gave me the tickets. The tickets was on sale for like, $600 for something like that. I wound up getting tickets for like $40. And I'm thinking, how can they afford to give away these $40 tickets? And my mind won't stop racing.
But what's your target audience? I'm just curious. Who do you want to come to this?
Content creators and entrepreneurs.
People that's aspiring to be, or people that's already?
Both.
Because I'm asking that because, like, bro, I know there's a difference between thinking broke, thinking rich. I get that. But I'm talking to a specific audience, a group of people who don't really have it, that's going to spend their last to come to this. And they ain't spending their last to come to see, oh, yeah, this went wrong. Man, I ain't even there yet.
Why not? What do you mean? Give me a good example. Put yourself in the shoes of somebody who wouldn't need to come that's a content creator or an entrepreneur.
No, not wouldn't need to come. I'm saying...
Or wouldn't come.
That wouldn't want to spend my last...
Let me try to convince you. Let's just create a scenario.
Okay. So, how much are tickets?
I think general admission might be $297.
Cool. Start there. Perfect. I spent $300 to come to this podcast summit, right? That's all I got. I'm not spending $300 to come to a summit to see what's wrong so I can create so I can do my own summit and not do what you didn't do. I'm not even there yet. I'm still trying to learn how to build an audience. So I come here and okay, what did I really learn? Yeah. Like I just wasted $300 of my dollars, bro.
Okay. So I built an audience.
Mm-hmm.
Right. How much? If let's say you're getting started, and I'm like, yo, I'm about to spend some time with you, and I'm going to answer some of your questions. How much would you pay? If I said, and put yourself in a young Jay Hill's situation, and you know what I built in the media space, and you want to get there, and I said, all right, well, what would be a price that you would invest to have a conversation with me? Or would you say I wouldn't?
So you're really asking me?
I'm asking
you,
Jay Hill. No,
I would.
Why?
Because what I'm willing to pay, because I'm willing to go get it.
Okay. All right. Take yourself out of that. You're Jay Hill.
Okay.
Put yourself in the position of the most negative person that you could think of.
Mm-hmm.
That's just not coming. And I have what you want. What would you pay me?
The most negative person probably wouldn't pay you anything.
Anything.
Mm-hmm.
For sure. That's not who I'm talking to.
Okay. But what about to the people that's like, yo, I'm here. Like, I'm in the middle. I'm almost there, bro. I'm investing in myself. I'm paying. I ain't going to get the $300 ticket. I'm going to get the $1,000 ticket. I don't know if you got
that. Let's go back to the $300 person that wouldn't pay me anything. Mm-hmm. That's simply foolishness. Mm. It's foolish. Like, think about the mindset. I have what you want, but you're not willing to part with your money to invest in information that could quite possibly change your life. Right?
Yeah.
You're a fool.
For sure. Right? I understand that.
I can't convince anybody. So what we're doing is creating a platform. Bro, I don't have $20,000, $10,000 tickets. It's $300. And the only reason we have $300 tickets is because there has to be some sort of barrier of entry. I'm doing you a favor by charging you, because if you don't invest nothing, you're not going to
take it serious.
You won't take it seriously.
100%. Now I'm with you.
You don't call me, right? Not a lot. Or text me. You don't.
Bro, what type of time are you on right now?
I'm asking you. How often do you text me?
Why are we talking to you,
How often do you text me?
This ain't my interview.
How often?
I don't know.
How often?
Not too much.
Not too much. Now, what if you paid me money every single month to be able to have access to me? How often would you text me?
Oh, every day.
And you'd have more information. But because you don't pay nothing to have this relationship, it's almost like it's worse off for people who know a successful person who has information, because you don't want to abuse the relationship.
100%, yeah.
But if you pay me, then I have to like come to your studio and look everything at, and like, yo, and look at your financial strategy. And I got to put a game plan together because you paid me.
Yeah.
And it's not even that I give better information if you pay me. It's just the fact that you're willing to go get your money's worth. Mm.
There's a lot of things you can do with $500. I mean, you can have a night out with your significant other. You could buy some really expensive shoes. Well, really nice shoes are about double $500. You could buy a course where you can learn something for $500. But I have something better for you to do with the $500. I want to meet with you every single morning for the rest of your life. Well, maybe not the rest of your life, but every morning, Monday through Friday, for the rest of the year. I have information and game that have allowed me to build a successful business, a successful community, and a successful life all the way around. But I want to share that with you. But the only way we can accomplish this is not me selling you a course, not me giving you a one-on-one consultation, because even with that, you'll get the information, but you'll need more. I want to meet with you every single morning. Now, would I meet with someone every morning for $500 for a year? And the answer is yes. Actually, we've been doing this thing since 2017. We have what's called the morning meetup. Every single month, we have a theme, whether it's social media, whether it's motivation, whether it's strategy, whatever it is, we have a theme for the month. And every morning in that month, we have a conversation around that topic. And I am giving a wealth of knowledge, not only myself, but a lot of friends, a lot of people that you see on this podcast, they join every single week. So you need a community of people that you can grow with, and you need a coach. I'm your coach. The Morning Meetup is your community. Go to themorningmeetup.com. It's $499, and I will meet you every single morning for an entire year. Give it a shot.
How can we get our money's worth in these, again, because we talking about these festivals, we talking about these big events, and it's been, man, I've seen on the internet, people was paying a lot of money, and they going to these big events, and they're, again, like I said, they're just hearing people testimonies. Like, how do, as a consumer who is willing to pay $300, $500, like, how do I network? How do I properly network? I think you wrote a book on it. How do I properly network, but how do I get my money's worth? Like, how do I do that?
You have to, like, before you come to any event, you need to make a list of things you need to take away from. So you might have, so before you went to that event that we both went to, you probably didn't make a list of things you need to, like, take away from.
Bro, this is not the hot seat, bro.
Yes, it is.
Stop putting it on me, bro. This is your interview.
No. This is going to be good. This is going to be good. And because this is going to help them.
Okay.
So think about the event we went to, right? Mm-hmm. And it was put on by a whole nother culture because there wasn't a whole lot of black people there.
Yeah, it wasn't.
If you could have really sat down and thought about it before you got there, what would you say? Okay, the reason I'm going is because I need to get this, this, and that. What would be the this, and that for you?
For me?
Yeah, for you.
I did that. It was sponsorships. Okay. So I spent most of my time at the vending tables and meeting the people that was at the vending tables.
What'd you learn?
What did I learn?
First off, did you get any sponsorships?
No, I got a couple potential situations that I didn't like.
Okay. Oh, so they wanted to give you bread?
Kinda. I didn't want, they wanted to do like, you do this for a certain amount of time and I give you an affiliate link, things like that. Gotcha. I wasn't really, that wasn't where I was at in my in my career.
Okay, so sponsorship, that's one. What else?
That was really it for me. That was really it.
Well, let's think of two more.
meet some potential guests for the show, of course.
Did you find some?
Potentially, yeah. I mean, it's funny because the people that I was asking to be sponsored, they would love to pay to be on the show so they could be guests and that could bring me more money to the podcast. Mm-hmm. But that was really, it was really a financial, I was really just going to see how I can turn this into a money play. I can give you one.
That's like, out of money. Think about it.
Building a team. So I know it's going to be young. It's going to be a lot of people recording, right? Let's see who is doing what, at what's their price, what's their budget? How can I make the opportunity better for them, right? How can I get them to do something that they might love, that they, you know what I'm saying? That can be something to build a team.
So we have these three things. How much would you, forget like going for like the speakers and all that kind of stuff, but it was a group of people and you had these three objectives. How much would you pay to get in a room so that you can like really go get these three? How much would you have paid? And just like think about it. How much, if I was like, yo, you can, I'm gonna give you an opportunity to go look for, you know, try to get some sponsorships, try to find these guests and really understand how teams work. Give me $1,000, I'll let you in this room. Would you invest it?
Yeah.
You would? Would you? Yes or no?
For the sake of the conversation, yeah.
No.
But it has to depend. It got to make sense.
Yes.
Like, again, I probably went to one of the biggest festivals in, or one of these type of events, and it was nothing, bro. Like, I ain't getting nothing from it. Like, I met a couple people, and then I lined up some interviews, so I'm lying. I don't think I would have paid $1,000 for that, though. I can honestly say I wouldn't have paid $1,000.
Those interviews that you lined up, did you make money from?
Yeah.
How much you think? Not from just like YouTube AdSense. Of course, you'll get YouTube or whatever. But think about other opportunities because you had those guests on there.
For sure. It's cool. $1,000.
That's what I'm saying, bro. You sound crazy.
Maybe.
Like I'm investing that $1,000 every time. Mm. Oh, it's going to be 5,000 people in this room? Oh, so I can get these things accomplished? I'm going. How much would I invest? 2,000, 3,000, 4,000, because I know I'm going to get something for the opportunity. Bro, I'm the person at the carnival that keeps putting the money in to drop the crane down to get the little bowl of money. I'm like, yo, I'm going to keep doing this joint till I...
You said I'm crazy. That's literally the definition of insanity.
How?
I mean, you keep doing the same thing over and over.
As an entrepreneur, that's all I've done my entire life. That's it. I shoot the shot. My boy, he put it to me this way. My man, AD Dolphin. He said, bro, I go for the pump fake every time. He's like, yo, if it seems like an opportunity, he said, I jump every time. I try. Listen, you going to get me. You going to pump fake me, I'm going to jump in the air. You going to pump fake me again, I'm going to jump in the air. But if I keep doing that, eventually you're going to shoot, I'm going to block it, and I'm going to hit my goal. I've done that 1,000 times. I've failed more times than I've succeeded by far. But them few wins, I've been to a bunch of dud events, but it was a couple events, bro. I'll never get it out of my mind. I went to this event, bro, and I was in network marketing. So prepaid legal was real big in DC before, right?
What is it called?
Prepaid legal.
Yeah, I heard that.
So I was in that. And I've been to a bunch of these conferences. First off, like the hype and the inspiration alone was worth it for me because you go back like with another sense of zeal, right? But there's so many, I remember this story that Darnell Self told and I brought, this had to be 2004, this had to be like 20 years ago. I'll never forget it. He told this story about there's like four monkeys in this cage or in this like this controlled environment. So think of like a glass square fish tank or something like that. And there's a tree in the middle of the box, right? And there's four monkeys in there. And he was telling this story. I'll never forget it. He said the monkey runs up the tree to get the bananas, and the scientists, they like spray the monkey with water. So the monkey screams and like comes back down the tree. And then the second monkey goes up to get the bananas. Same thing happens to him. Scientists spray the monkey with the water. He screams, comes back down the tree. The third monkey tries to go up. The first two monkeys are saying, hey, don't go up there, trying to pull the monkey down, along with the fourth monkey, who didn't even go up, but he saw what happened. Mm-hmm. So he said the scientist did something. He said the scientist replaced the first monkey with a new monkey. The new monkey sees the banana, say, yo, I'm about to go up this tree and get these bananas. The second monkey who got sprayed with the water, the third monkey who never been up the tree, the fourth monkey who didn't even attempt to go up the tree is all saying, hey, don't go up there. You don't want to do that. They replaced the second monkey with a new monkey. Now, none of these monkeys have ever gone up the tree, but they're all pulling each other down for reasons they know not of. I'll never forget the story. And that told me, I said, yo, never start believing people because of what they've been conditioned to do or what they think is going to happen or their particular fear, because most of the people telling me not to do what I'm going to do have never done it, period. Mm-hmm. Think about all the people that are telling you not to do something. They've never done it. All the people that tell you don't start a podcast, they've never done it or they've never made any money from it. So won't you come learn from somebody and dozens of other people who have made money from podcasting. You made money from podcasting, right? Mm-hmm. You gonna be there? Mm-hmm. You gonna give people some game or you gonna hold it?
100%.
Yo, I've curated like 30, 40 people who are like masters of their craft in content creation, podcasting, how to get the money. I'm bringing advertising agencies. I'm bringing people. Like, there's so many experts in these crafts that are all coming to get the game. And if you say, yo, I want to get this, this, and this from this conference, and I'm not leaving until I get it, I guarantee you, or your money back, you will get it. Because you're going with intention. It's just most people go to events without intention.
That's 100%. This is good, bro. Like, you make me, I'm already a believer, but like, you just make me like a re-believer. That's what, like, I'm like, she's like, damn, I'm about to buy a ticket. I'm about to buy one for somebody. Yo, no, so, but again, I hear that, and that's dope. But I still don't, like, what's in it for you? Like, what's, because I'm, you ask me a question, I'm definitely giving a game, but like, why do we do this?
Hopefully I make money from the event. Hopefully I make money from the event. But the objective is, I always see an area where other people aren't and I want to create something. Like, I don't see what everybody else is doing and I want to do that. Like, I'm going to keep it 100 with you. Literally this morning, and I don't think we talked about it, but this morning I was like, yo, I want to make a post, bro. I don't want to interview people at all anymore. Mm. Like, I don't want to interview nobody.
I understand. Because
everybody's interviewing people. I don't like it, bro. And I'm literally thinking about just going down to me and Donnie having conversation and doing hot seat. Mm. Why? Because there's no other two people that are entrepreneurs in the entrepreneurial space, given entrepreneurial game out there that we know of that can do what me and Donnie do. And there is no other hot seat yet. Someone's going to take it for sure and try to duplicate it. But right now it's going to be very difficult to duplicate it because I understand business and you got to have personality. And there's a bunch of things that it'll be hard to duplicate. So I don't want to interview people.
Bro, I get it. I ain't gonna lie. I'm with you. But if you don't interview people, you always could just put me on your network, let me interview them, and then you could just pay me the bag, and then I could stop interviewing the people I interviewed. Then we all went. You feel me?
That's true. That's you doing not too bad yourself, bro.
Yo, can I ask you a question though, for real? Like, outside of like getting ticket sales and stuff like that, mm-hmm. What you think is the hardest part of this? Like, putting this summit together.
Getting people to believe you that this thing is going to change your life. The actual getting the venue and the cameras and getting the agenda. And I am blessed because I have some amazing relationships with people who are in the space, and they're like, yo, I'm gonna come whatever you need, because I've helped so many people along my career. The hardest part is getting people to believe that this event is like, it's a gold rush of media. Mm. So that's the hardest part. That's why I'm on this 10 city tour now.
Yo, you asked me people that I know that could like help give like, you know, speeches and like be a special guest. And I was like, man, the people I know that's really good at this, they don't really get the recognition. You know what I'm saying? Like, they're not the most popular. And I was wondering, why is that? Why do you think that?
Man, let me tell you, bro. We did a survey from last year's workshop, last year's podcast summit. And the big names ranked least favorite.
I can believe it.
Bro, it was the people that you never heard of, like a Hala Taha or a Jessica Hurley or Mario Armstrong or Omar or Marshall Fox, who stays in his hole. Don't even have an Instagram, bro. The survey from Marshall's, so he does a lot of he does all my logos and he just does amazing branding. So he did a workshop on like getting your virtual aesthetics together. Bro, one of the top ranked sessions from the survey. He doesn't even have an Instagram. So like I'm not even chasing celebrities right now. I'm chasing information. I'm asking people to come for the information, not because I got Rick Ross coming or anything, because we did that last year and it was a disaster. We had Love and Hip Hop come because I was like, ooh, this would be a good opportunity for some exposure. We had a select, it was a disaster. And nobody was feeling it. It was like, yo, Dave, let's get back to teaching. So this year we back to teaching. We are not celebrity chasing.
What was like the most interesting part for you? Like, what was the thing?
Last year?
Yeah, did you learn something? Like, what was the wild moment for you?
I was running around the whole time. That was a blur. The best part was when I got the recap video, which we'll play at the end of this video. But yeah, it was the recap video, just being able to see it afterwards. But bro, it's all a blur for me at the event. Them 2 days.
So what are you doing differently to make it better?
Doubling down on content, doubling down on experience and information. Last year, we had this idea to put like podcast booths.
Yeah,
around the venue.
Yeah.
So we had like 10 podcast booths where people can sit down and interview people live. So instead of 10, we're probably going with 30 this year because we want people to have more engaged conversations. Every speaker, everybody that's been on the Social Proof podcast, I'm inviting them to come to Podcast Summit and I'm asking them to sit down and do interviews with the people that are there. So even if you are a guest, right, you might be like, yo, I love Neo or I love B. Simone or I love, you know, all these different people. And I can't guarantee that a lot of them came last year and it was tougher going to Miami, and most of Atlanta's a really good city. But they're coming and you're going to see us dropping these testimonials like, yo, my name is so-and-so. I'm coming to do some interviews with 10 podcasters. So I'm giving the people that are watching my show as aspiring podcasters the same interviews that I got. And I'm literally giving them an opportunity to come for free. I'm giving them a ticket, yo, just come. You've been on the podcast, come for free. But your requirement is I'm asking you to sit down with a few smaller podcasters. And when I've been talking to them about it, they're like, yo, oh, bet. Because it makes sense for them. Some of them got super hype. He was like, yo, I'm about to try to do 30 of them joints because their brand goes around 30 times to 30 different audiences. And the podcast is like, yo, I always wanted to sit down with, I don't know, Herman or my man Dion or all the people that's been on Social Proof Podcast. I'm trying to level the playing field for everybody.
Bro, that's, I pay $1,000 for that. I'm gonna tell you, no cap. Because like a lot of times, even when I asked you your story and I wanted to paint that picture of your story, I don't think it was somebody, and you could correct me if I'm wrong, that had to tell you, yo, you should do this, right? Mm-hmm. You started and then you start getting advice. Same with your team. You know what I'm saying? Like same with like me. You feel me? Like it was, I wanted to do something, I did it, and I had to make some mistakes, right? Mm-hmm. And a lot of these conferences, it's like, I think it's pitch for the person that you got to tell to do something. And it's like, bro, like, if you want to do something, you asking me how to do it, you clearly don't want to do it good a bit. You don't want to do it that much, right? I say that to say you really have something tangible for the people that are doing it, for the people that are taking the first step and not the summit. The summit ain't the first step. The people that are taking the first step saying, yo, I'm going to do this, man. Come to the summit. Now they are able to build a portfolio. They are able to build a profile because they can interview people with names even if they feel like they aren't somebody. You feel me? And I think that right there, that's special, bro. Like even when I seen the booth, I'm like, man, that's fire. And not to ramble, but like, I'm not gonna lie, man. I'm not just saying this to co-sign you. Like, you my dog, but I'm me. You feel me? Regardless. I don't need nobody to validate me regardless. But like, you are one of the only people that, bro, I've never in my life met somebody like you. I'm being real. Like, no, respectfully, bro. I know I keep saying this, but I don't have to do this, but like, yo, you had me in a room and like, you had your numbers up. The audio numbers, how much you made that year. And I'm like, whoo. But the fact that you had me in there giving me the game for free, you on the phone with the guy like from Red Circle, you know what I'm saying, talking about other sponsors. When you get sponsorships, you post it on Instagram. So I genuinely can be like, man, nah, bro, he got his best interest. Like he has your best interest at heart. And I feel like people should come because like you ain't just throwing it, like we said earlier. It ain't a measuring contest, right? It's really for people to get game. And that's why I genuinely think people will enjoy it. And I hope people learn from the interview and I hope people trust you a little bit more.
Yeah, absolutely. We're gonna do a promo code real quick. I'm just gonna make it right now.
Let's do it.
What you want? Where'd my phone go?
Don't play with me. Don't ask me no question.
We're gonna do a promo code.
What's up?
Yo, we're gonna do a promo code real quick. And I'm gonna let you make the promo code. I'm gonna set it up right now. I'm gonna let you make the promo code. And never mind, because I was gonna say that you could tell me what percentage you want.
Yeah,
we not doing that.
Yeah, because you know I'm with the people. You know I'm for the people.
We not doing that.
Hey, listen, I'm not a regular person. I am that guy who came up with one mother and I ain't had no backyard and it was struggling. I was struggling to eat. That's me. So for sure, we going to.
So what do you think? 25%? 25% is a lot.
Bro, you playing with these people. Let me see something.
What you mean, bro?
Let me see something. Hold up.
First off, it's already discounted right now. It's early bird. And I'm saying we'll take another percentage off.
What's the early bird?
So like general admissions, $297.
Right.
Like it's $500 tickets for the event. It's right now $297.
That's early bird tickets.
Early bird is $297.
God damn.
Is that a lot? Is it a lot?
Not for me, but I'm thinking about the people. I'm just thinking about
Think about this. Think about the person that you're thinking about. Think about like a real person that you know.
So for the promo code.
Hold on. No. Think about the real person that you know that needs to come. Do you know a person that has a real name?
Yeah.
You know that person. Mm-hmm. Okay. Don't say their name. Give another name.
Okay.
What's their other? Chris.
Mm-hmm.
What does Chris do for a living?
Chris do something that I can't mention on a podcast for a living.
Oh, it's illegal?
Yeah, and then he do the...
Why wouldn't he invest $300? What kind of shoes he got on his feet right now?
He lives...
Is $297 when he's wearing $250 sneakers right now too much?
It might not be.
Okay, think of... Okay, you said...
So you asked me about a promo code, man. Come on, man.
That's what I'm saying, though, bro. Like, we got...
So, wait, all right, so...
I'm trying to help them understand.
Okay, cool,
like,
cool,
their
cool.
priorities are so out of whack.
Cool, cool. Hold on. You asked me about a promo code.
Yes.
What's the exact date?
July 4th and 5th.
July 4th. So it's February. Can we... You said 25% off?
I should have started low.
Can we do?
And then he said like, "Oh, 30."
Hey, I'm
like,
I told right, you. What's your guy's name? EYL pulled up to you ain't even know. Pulled up to the live event. Try to give like a couple tickets. Like, no, we need like 100. They did it though.
They had 20 seats for 20,000.
Cool. You gonna have at least 1,000.
No, we're gonna have 1,500 people.
1,500. So you can give me.
But I can't give away tickets.
No, not for free.
I'm just saying. This event's going to sell
nothing
out.
Nothing for free, bro. I ain't asking for free. I'm saying a discounted code, a good discounted code for a limited time. That's it. I ain't even asking for a long time.
I got you. You know what? I got you. This is what I'm going to do. This is what I'm going to do. For a limited time, this is what I'm going to do. Because they have to put a code in there.
We can do 30 days. We can do...
All right, bet.
11, 12 days. It could be... I'm saying let's do a good number, though.
All right, this is what I'm going to do. You ready?
I'm hearing you.
So what I'm going to do is... Anyone who uses whatever code you create.
Mm-hmm.
Any code you create, we'll do
45.
Here's what I'll do. They'll be able to get an additional ticket. So buy one, get one. So that's two tickets for the price of one.
Mm.
And because I have to put a code, I don't know how to do that, just like that. But we'll do... 10% because I have to put a percentage on there.
Mm-hmm.
10% off. But anybody that uses this particular code will get, they'll be able to bring somebody with them. What code?
That's worth it. Because if you're a creator, I can bring my camera person. Yes. I can bring my friend.
Yeah.
Mm. How long are we going to do this? Because like, I want it to be limited. I want you to get your money.
21
days.
This is actually going to drop. Okay. All right. All right.
21 days.
1 days after it drops. Yes. Okay. What's the code you want? J Hill.
I should do Mr. J Hill so they can follow me and remember me. I ain't going to be that vain. Let's do for the people. Not too much.
It's corny. It's just.
It could be corny. It's for you.
Nah. I mean, make it something. We could do J Hill.
Let's do J Hill. Let's do it.
J-A-Y-H-I-L-L.
Yeah. Buy one, get one free, 21 days. Come on, man. Y'all better appreciate what you got going on right here.
Okay.
It looked like he almost sweated in here. Kay, what you think? It looked like he was about to sweat, no?
Mm.
No? No?
Okay. That's a lot, right?
Hey, it's cool. It's done. We already said it. We ain't about to edit nothing. No, we live, right?
It's live. It's oh
yeah. We live.
Oh, I forgot we're live right now.
Yeah, we live, right? Yeah.
Oh, that's crazy.
Yeah.
Oh, let me see.
Yeah, you ain't no reneging. Yeah. And we ain't doing that.
Oh yeah. Oh yeah. I'm just going. Okay.
Yeah, we live, baby. I forgot. Yeah. He was about to say, "Damn, that's a lie." Okay. Changed my mind.
Okay. All right, now I got you. So not only is it going to take 10% off, but also, okay. All right.
Let's get it.
What's up?
Again, I appreciate the platform, bro. I really appreciate.
Oh, we got to tell them podcastsummit.com.
Podcastsummit.com.
Come on, bro. You're the host, bro. Podcastsummit.com, July 4th and 5th. Come on, man. Come on.
You just said
man.
It, yo.
I'm your guest, but you the host. You want to sit there?
Podcastsummit.com. Make sure you go get your tickets. Whenever this drop, we're going to drop a promo for 21 days. So listen, if you are somebody who might be skeptical, if somebody that you don't think is worth it, we're giving you 50% off for the most part. We're giving you buy one, get one free, and an additional 10% off for 21 days. So you can bring your cameraman if you do content. You can bring a friend if you want your friend to get into podcast. You can do all that. July 4th and 5th, podcastsummit.com. Trust me, this is me. Where my camera? Listen, this is me. I ain't no big time entrepreneur. For some of you, you might see my podcast. You might think I'm a big deal, but I ain't even that yet. Trust me. This is somebody who came from really, 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 really hard times. And I'm telling you, I'm backing this guy, David Shands. He's somebody who really cares about content creators. And if you are into content, if you are into podcasts, if you're thinking about creating a podcast, you can trust me. Because where I'm from, I ain't from the regular place where he from. Where I'm from, our name, it can cost you a lot. And that's all I'm going to say because I'm being cognizant of the platform I'm on. So trust me, I'm giving you my word that he's somebody that you can trust, not only with your money, but with your time. Trust me, go to podcastsummit.com, July 4th, July 5th, right here in Atlanta. It's something that you don't want to miss.
Thanks for having me on my show, bro.
Alrighty, thanks for allowing me to have you on your show.
That was good, bro. That was all right, man.
If you like the video that you just watched, click this one. You're going to like this one, maybe even more. Click it right now. I like that.
Stop the cap.
All right, man. I'm going to go home.
All right, brother. This is good, man. I appreciate it again.
Thanks for having me, bro.
Yeah, thanks for having me.